We are going to get started in just a second. Welcome to your Friday. Woo! We are minutes of Lamania opening, but I'm here right now, so I may have to take a little quick pause so I can announce Lamania being open, but we are just getting ready to do it. Big exciting weekend as well on Lamania, so that's why I've got my hip chat open so that I can monitor when Lamania is open. I am on Kaneth. I'm on Seitan, S-E-I-T-A-N, level 8 druid. May switch over if no one joins my party, but if people join the party, then we'll be running this throughout the hour. I say otherwise I might actually head over to Thalanus because I need to flag for Giant Old Tor. All I have left is Giant Old Tor, then I can run Fall of Truth tonight. Like the sweater? Yeah, yeah. Let's see if I can... There we go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I like it. All right, so hello and welcome to Fridays at 4 here on twitch.tv/DDOstream and youtube.com/dungeonsanddragons/live. I am DDO Community Manager Cordovan. Thank you very much for joining me. It's Friday. It's time for an awesome DDO weekend. We have got plus 25% epic XP going on through the weekend. We have some killer sales in the DDO store. You can find out information about that at DDO.com/store. We also are within minutes of opening up Lamania to our second preview of Update 29. That's going to include Legendary Shroud, Legendary Hound Azoriat, Legendary Tempest Spine, Legendary Greensteel, new random loot, named items in the Test Dojo. Some pretty awesome stuff. So, huge time to be checking things out on Lamania, and we're going to be leaving Lamania open through the weekend here to make sure we get lots of feedback. What we'd really like you to do is not spend your whole time sitting in the Test Dojo. We'd love it if you would go, run through a bunch of quests, hit those random chests, get that random loot, give us good feedback on it, run Legendary Shroud, run the new raids, find the bugs, let us know about them. Give us some good qualitative feedback, so as soon as we can get back to work on Monday morning, we can cruise through and get a lot of stuff done. But do what you want. Tonight, actually, let me double check my forum post on that, but I know QA is going to be on tonight, and then I'm going to be on Saturday from around 11 to 2. 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Eastern, Saturday, December 5th. I'll be on, some of QA will be on, some of the devs will be on. Lamania will be there to answer questions, help you through the process. Additionally, tonight, Friday, December 4th, 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. Eastern, our QA folks are going to be on Lamania to help you out and take your feedback and answer your questions and get a little crazy. Urlock says, random loot is game-changing. Thanks. We think it's going to be pretty good as well. Hopefully, Kaneth Crafting is just as forward-thinking. I can tell you that in many ways, Kaneth Crafting is going to echo what you're seeing here on Random Loot Gen. One of the reasons we waited on Random Loot Gen or waited on Kaneth Crafting is so that it can align more closely to a randomized loot system, because it's a fairly significant overhaul to the way sort of non-named items work, and so it just made sense to align Kaneth Crafting with that. So when you see our Kaneth Crafting revamp, it's going to be informed pretty significantly from that random gen loot idea. Mostly random games. Thanks for the hand wraps and the new update. Yep, we got some new hand wraps coming. Let's see. Make, I thought I would run Irestone because of coins. But oh yeah, by the way, Festivalt coins are appearing. The Jester is not quite here yet. I believe he'll probably show up very soon after Update 29 goes live, and the reason for that is because we want to have the new cookies for the year. You know, we tend to change up the cookies a little bit. every year, and that needs to be done in a build, and that build's going to be update 29. So if we were to turn on the jester before update 29 hit, the cookies had changed midstream, and that didn't make any sense. So instead, the cookies are going to be a little bit later, but they'll stick around for the same amount of time. Sorry, Urlok, we're not getting Evards. Don't think I didn't think about it, but unfortunately, there's a suspicion that Evard's black tentacles may be a little performance intensive, shall we say, and so it would not be wise to drop those in cookie form. But I can tell you we do have some pretty cool things, because guess who got to make up the list? This guy. Maybe I'll look on my page here and drop a couple of hints. Yeah, well, it's all about those coins, right? Yeah, so. There may not be a better place to get Festivault coins at this level. Oh yeah, Kobold's new ringleader is good too, but this is a little higher level. Depends on your level, I guess. So. Yay, silver coin. By the way, I've got YouTube chat up as well, so this time around I can actually keep an eye on both. I popped out the Twitch chat, so it was a little bit easier to see. Ultimately, I need like a third monitor or something, but I haven't quite made that happen yet, so... Ideally, it would be really nice if there was some kind of app meant for us Twitch streamers to just sort of integrate YouTube and Twitch chat into one chat room, and we could just go ahead and use that. I suspect that'll happen someday, but we'll see. Urlok says, Jewels of Fortune and the new random loot system seems a little bit wonky in your words. I can tell you we are looking at some different ways to sort of deal with that. I think you're going to like what we come up with, but the Jewels of Fortune will work as they always do in terms of raising the level of the chest. So if you have a CR10 chest and a +2 loot boost, it'll be a CR12 chest. And really what that's going to do under the new random loot system as it currently sits on Lamania is allow you to get higher level items, more powerful items. You know, and so for example, like if you are in a level 10 quest and you got a +2 loot boost, it'll be a level 12 chest and you'll get level 12 power items. So your items will be directly more powerful. It is a little bit of a derivation from how it currently works, but it has some benefits. You're right, Urlok, that the way it currently sits on Lamania with these current potions is it will change the minimum level of the loot you'll get. By making it more powerful, it also increases the minimum level. Yeah. We'll have more information on that, you know, as we get a little bit closer to update 29 and there on. I should also mention that next Friday, at about this time, I think we'll probably just have it start at 4 unless there's some scheduling reason not to. We're going to have our Update 29 preview live right here, twitch.tv/DDOstream. Ooh, plus one perform, Tom, huh? It's kind of cool. And youtube.com/DungeonsandDragons/live. So Friday, 4 o'clock. Next week will be a special Friday at 4, where it's going to be our Update 29 preview. Probably have as many of the devs as we can wrangle into a room to do a quick run-through, answer your questions, do some awesome Q&A. Look at the green steel and what have you. Should be pretty cool. And we'll get out more of a promotion on that next week. We just sort of worked out that schedule today. And should be pretty cool. Looking forward to it. These previews are one of the more fun things we get to do. I know, oops. Hey, good thing I'm right next to a restaurant, huh? Yeah, it may be up right now. Let me actually pop on over to our chat and see what I see. All right. Yes, Lamania is now open. So that is open. I'll have to get the word out on that as soon as I get done with the live stream here. Well, and I don't know if you guys just want to watch me type on a computer for, like, 10-15 minutes. But I suppose I could. I mean, I'm really close to doing it. I suppose maybe I should get the release notes out. We'll see. Timing isn't perfect, but... But, you know, they want to get it up as soon as they can. It's been pretty exciting seeing this stuff together. I mentioned, I think, on the, did I mention on the Wednesday stream? Was it Wednesday that we were doing the dev run-through in the afternoon of Legendary Shroud? We did. And it went pretty well. We actually managed to get through it. We found a few things to work on here before today's preview on Lamania, so that was sort of the purpose of it. It was cool to run through the Shroud, Legendary Shroud, as a group. I'd sort of been keeping myself personally fairly spoiler-free on it, just because it's Trout, right? but you know, I have to give up some of that ability to not know what's coming, to do my job. And so I waited until this Wednesday to really dig into Legendary Shroud, and so it was my first really experience in there, personally, outside of just sort of hearing about it, and it was a lot of fun. Pretty funny, I actually got assigned to portal killer duty, and I don't know if I'd ever actually done that before. I don't know that I've ever, you know, because I don't typically play a lot of casters, and so it just kind of funny. It was like, wow, after all these years, I finally become the portal killer in a Shroud run? What the heck? But I did, and I did it, so... Thank you. Portal Keeper Killer, I guess I should say. Yeah, I'm looking forward to this is going to be a fun weekend. I don't have too much actually in the agenda. And I'm going to be on Lemania. Then I'm going to probably get in some DDO time. I got pen and paper group tonight, which is why I won't be on Lemania, sorry. Got my Friday night static group when I get home. Should be pretty cool. It was a crazy day in the office today. We did a bunch of, oh no, behind the scenes sort of email work. Switched over to a different email system, so that's always fun. Man, I gotta get out. I did Rabbit Asks. I don't know if this has been explained elsewhere, but why no legendary green steel hand wraps? And will they be possibly added in later after Monks and Wraps update sometime next year? You're correct in your assumption that the reason we're not bringing in legendary green steel hand wraps in with update 29 is we have a lot of hand wraps work to do, and that work was not able to get done in time for update 29. So we were not able to include legendary hand wraps, legendary green steel hand wraps. You know, it should be noted there are no heroic green steel hand wraps either. So, you know, at least in that regard, we're consistent. As to when it will be added, will it be added later? That's going to be a design call that we'll have to make at a later time. I don't know that I want to commit ourselves 100% to it, but we have heard your feedback on your desire to do it, and we'll let you know. It's definitely something that if we were to add it into Legendary Green Steel, it would have to be done after we did a bunch of hand wrap work here, which is slated for this next year. I think I got all the powder kegs I need. I think I grabbed them all. Can't remember if I did or not. Guess we'll find out. So far, Erlock says, the legendary green steel system looks good, basically as good as heroic green steel. Yeah, I think you know you can take a look-see in terms of the overall system right now. There's a forum thread on Lemania. Additionally, if you want to go to the Lemania server, you can actually play around with it a little bit. It should be noted, of course, that since this just made its first Lemania debut, it's not in 100% state. It's got a few things we need to work on yet, but it's a good first preview. And yeah, Crexus Pendragon, we aren't yet ready to announce a formal release date for Update 29, but the plan is to try to get it out in time for the holidays. It's about as much as I want to commit to at this time. Let's see. Make sure your voice of the master is on. Newsletter next week, maybe? No, it's probably going to be a little longer than that. In terms of the next producer's letter, we're actually trying to decide whether or not we're going to be able to get it out, say, maybe it might be kind of early January. I don't know, because we have a lot of stuff to talk about here for Update 29 and such, and we don't want to mix that up too much. So we'll see. We might be able to get it out, but if it's not out in time for, say, the holidays, it'll be shortly afterwards. Oh yeah, I missed the boss chest. Yeah, whatever. Let's see. Make, how's your trapping skills? Can we do Gwillins? Do you have any rogue? Yeah, you got some rogue. Yeah, probably did have a gold coin. All right, let me see if I can drop some knowledge. I'm going to see if I can update the release notes here quick. Sorry, I'm just looking over the release notes. Right, I think they're good enough to go, so let us... Let me get that out so you guys can read it if you want. Known issues. Alright, I'll rename the forum titles, the thread titles later, but the known issues and the release notes are now updated. So there you go. I just know Gwilyn's has a fair number of chests as well, so that might be a good one for coin getting. Welcome. We're on our way over to Gwilyn's stand. Do I actually have an airship? Here we go. So what do you guys got going on this weekend? Anything cool? Any DDO plans yourself? What will you be running? It was interesting. Someone asked me a question, I guess today, that I thought was a fairly interesting one, which is, you know, last weekend we had our big buddy weekend with both quest XP and raid XP bonuses based on the number of people in your party. And my curiosity is this. Do you think it did it lead you to think more about raiding or more about questing? Given basically the choice between a bonus for raiding and questing on the buddy weekend, did you tend to side one over the other, or was it pretty much a case of, hey, whichever one you want is all good? My own experience was I actually did a lot of raiding last weekend, but that was just me, right? So that could have just been the groups I was hanging out with and the people I knew. I don't know about that. Virtual Gibbs says Buddy XP should be the quote standard. I don't know, we kind of do want it to be a special occasion. I don't know that it would retain its excitement if it was just on 24/7. I also think that it might, you know, we want you to be able to play the way that you want to play. And if the way you want to play is you prefer to sometimes run by yourself or whatever, we don't want to make you kind of feel bad for making that choice, right? So, we'll see. We'll see. We appreciate the feedback, though, and we'd like to hear as much of it as you want to give us. Yeah, Bond 5? Uh-huh. Got that right. I might have done a few Bond 5s. Yeah. Also ran Fall of Truth, Caught in the Web, Deathworm, Fire and Thunder Peak. That was a busy raider this weekend. I'm sorry. Javur, I really don't understand what your comment is. I'm not sure what you're asking. Oh, the Risi Ice Games? Yeah. Those should be coming in January, along with the Midwinter Festival and Evening Star. And we'll have more specific date and time for that as we get closer to it. But first up is going to be Festival, and that's going to be arriving. Well, the coins are dropping now, and the Jester should be showing up fairly soon here. And probably go through the early part of the new year. You know, Javor, I am also not a very good Rizia ice jumper. As a matter of fact, I may be a notoriously bad one. I think just something about the Rizia Ice Games. I cannot wrap my head around it. You know, Lessa's tried to show me the her tips because she's a pro at it and everything, and just I don't know, just not good. Well, that's true. That's true. This year I've got Favored Soul with wings, so I should be in a lot better shape. But yeah. Yeah, for sure. Yep. So maybe this will be the year for me. Well, I'm actually also looking forward to the Midwinter Festival, because you can do some nice stuff there as well. But I plan to. That's always a fun one. I like to do that one during lunch because it's nice and casual in terms of the ice skating on Midwinter. You can sort of do it while you're eating lunch and stuff. Works out pretty well. Yes, you're right. We have lots of new loot in Update 29. Our loot folks have been very, very busy. I mean, not even including just the whole legendary Greensteel, which is a massive loot system, you know? Yeah, some of the items haven't actually been named yet on Lamania. They're just sort of using placeholder names. So that's what's up with that. We are planning to do at least one more Lamania push. I think the current plan is to try to take a build from somewhere late next week. So we have plenty of time to, say, grab the feedback from this weekend Lamania and, you know, make some changes and adjustments and really dig into all that stuff. Probably work on it, you know, throughout the week, take a build later in the week, and then use that for a third Lamania update. TBA. Don't know yet. Yeah, item with negative healing amp, huh? Not bad, huh? Pretty cool. Any Atari 2600 nerds out there, like myself? I got quite lucky this weekend.
is awesome.
I found one of the rarest Atari carts I've ever seen. As a matter of fact, it is the, at least according to Atari Age's rarity guide, the rarest Atari cart in my collection. It's a game called Guardian by Apollo Games. It was pretty awesome. I love it. If, I don't know if you're, any of you guys are old classic gamers, like old school collectors like myself, but when you see one of those like rare carts, you're like, yeah! It was very cool. Erlock says, in Legendary Green Steel, will we be able to unslot or change augments? The answer is yes. We're going to be having some sort of augment, a Legendary Green Steel augment extractor that'll be available. Stay tuned for more information on that, but there will be a way to do that. You can also just overwrite your augments if you would prefer to do that, but we are going to have a way to unslot them. Yeah, it's going to be something like that, Erlock. Kind of like a dopant slash toolkit thing. Yeah. Yes, we also, like you mentioned, ooh, Minotaur hair belt. All right. Otherwise known as the Gibbous Swashbuckler. But anyway, I was going to say that with Update 29, we are going to have a new thing on your inventory sheet to slot green steel augments. With Update 29, that's going to be for green steel, but clearly that may be something we can expand upon in the future. And when we have more information about that, we'll let you know. But you know, I think you can sort of think about how else it might be used related to augments. Will we be able to make... Will we still be able to make dog collars out of hand wraps? Yes. Why wouldn't you be able to? I don't understand why you think you wouldn't. But yes, that functionality will remain. Using a Trapsmith workstation. Oh, maybe because of the random gin loot thing? Yeah, it should be fine. It's a good question, though, to make sure that we double-check that. I'll ask about that when I can. But there should be no reason why it wouldn't work. As a matter of fact, I suppose it would probably, theoretically, maybe even be better, right? Because you're going to have the potential for some pretty nice stuff on random gin loot. She also raised a good question, which is, I wonder what it looks like on the Iron Defender with the new named hand wraps. I haven't seen yet. I will have to check. What else should I mention? I guess... Yeah, I don't know. It's been a good week. Been a really busy week. Oh, I know what I could mention. We have got three new streamers. You saw the first one yesterday, if you were around on twitch.tv at around, or was it, around 1 o'clock. Musk from Argonessen is streaming now on DDO Stream, in addition to his own channel, which is slash Gary782. He's now joined the DDO Stream team. We have got two more. We have got one showing up, I believe, as soon as Monday. And would actually need to look up the name of his channel. I don't have it off the top of my head here. Strim Tom. Yeah, and so Strim Tom, that'll be Monday, 7 p.m. from about 7 to 9, or 7 to 10. And then on Wednesdays, we have a morning show before the weekly Wednesday lunchtime live stream. I've been able to convince Samus Garobo to do some streaming on Wednesday mornings. So he's going to be kind of an opener, place person to hang out with and have fun with for the weekly Wednesday lunchtime live stream. So that'll be, we have new shows Monday at 7, Wednesday at 9 in the morning, and then Thursday at 1 in the afternoon. Pretty cool. There's still room too, as a matter of fact. So if you are hearing this and saying, "Dang, I want to be on the live stream," you can. You need a little. I mean, we're not picky in terms of, you know. We're pretty open. This is a community channel, right? So anyone who wants to stream that has a basic knowledge of how to do it is able to. You do need to have a basic knowledge of how to stream. If you've never live streamed before in your life, you might want to get a little practice before you get to the DDO stream. But what if you've done some Twitch streaming? We'd love to have you on. So get in touch with me. You can either do that through Twitch, through Twitter, Facebook, DDO forums. However you want to get in touch with me is fine. And let me know kind of what you'd like to do, maybe what your time slot would be. You can find our full schedule on twitch.tv slash DDO stream. I'm actually going to be updating that schedule today to reflect the newest shows when I'm done here. Was hoping to get it out in time for the live stream, but I was in a meeting and such, so. Are there any rumors we can get about DDO's birthday next year? Man, I really don't want to spoil anything. Nah, I don't want to spoil anything. I can tell you that it'll be similar to other years in the past where we've done, say, some free gifts and various sort of celebratory events. We do have an update plan for around that time. Well, probably update 30 will be out around that time. And that's going to have Gnome along with other things. Well, that's probably going to have Gnome. That's what we're planning. Right now we have a whiteboard that says U30 equals gnome. Yeah, second screen really helps for Twitch streaming. You know, last Friday I was streaming from home and I only have one screen at home myself, and it really makes it kind of tough to check up on chat and everything. Really helps to have the side screen where you can drop the chat. Although I suppose if you have an iPad or something, that works too, but I don't have that either, so. Ingenious debilitation, conquest, and ransack. Voices, everybody. Oh, actually, I suppose we could do that last chest, huh? Hey, Titan. We have a lot of halflings in my pen and paper group this time, including me. We also have probably the most evil, lawful good cleric I've ever played or with. A cleric of light, although you wouldn't know it based on the amount of things he's done. How about I not die? Should be over here, Mick. Let's see, what else can we do that's a fairly short one? Yeah, Titan, it was nice to see you got joined those of us with cameras. I don't even know I've ever seen what you look like until now. Think we could maybe do Church and the Cult on normal, huh? Or we could, no, I know what we can do. We can do, cage trolls. Sorry, I'm not going to do Purge the Heretics on the live stream. Make people cry. I laugh at the nasty face of evil. Where did I get this sweater? I got this sweater at TwitchCon this year. One of the vendors had it. And I saw it and I was like, ooh. If there's a sweater that screams me, it would definitely be one with a beholder on it. Did I get to be on the dev internal server today? No, I did not have time. I was really busy today. Still really busy. When I get off the live stream here, I have quite a bit more work to do before I call it a day. Something about releasing Lamani on a Friday afternoon with green steel and what have you. Sometimes I think we're nuts. What were we thinking? But is it fun to be on that server? I guess. I mean, it's cool. It's certainly cool to see things in progress and all the rest. But, you know, when you're on an admin doing that kind of work, you tend to be like actually doing work, you know, testing things, looking at up information, putting together guides, you know, checking things out qualitatively. I mean, there's just all sorts of stuff you're actually doing, right? So, you know, it's not like I'm hanging out and just putzing around. I mean, don't get me wrong. It's really, really cool, fun work, but it, you know, there is an actual job being done here, so. I like it, Crixus. Is the Hound a raid or no? Yes. Legendary Hound of Zoriet is a raid. check it out, Titan. It's a pretty good raid. Back in the day, it used to be quite a popular one. Boot. What's with making brand new items? Just a decision. Cool. Alright, I think that's probably going to wrap it up. I appreciate you guys taking a few minutes with me. Yeah, Hound of Zoria is going to be a lot of fun. I can't wait to check it out, and you can actually check it out this weekend if you want to join us on Lemania. You can go to the DDO forums if you want to find out more about how to do that. Otherwise, we will see you in-game. We got 25% Epic XP this weekend, some cool stuff on sale. This is actually the first week of our December deals as well. Yeah, you can find that on DDO.com/store. We have streaming this weekend. Pikers Anonymous is at 8:30 tonight. I believe someone's going to be filling in for the Bitsy and Mattson show because they have something going on this weekend, so they can't make it. Titan, I believe you were maybe going to stream on Sunday, and then on Monday we'll have our new show at 7 p.m. along with Minion Monday, which takes place 4 p.m. Eastern right here on twitch.tv/DDOstream. We do the archives both on Twitch and on youtube.com/DungeonsAndDragons. Hope you have fun. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.